Guys, it's Burrito here. Just making a quick video to show you about the Burrito tool, the features, that sort of thing. So first off, we've got the main sort of interface here. Once you've searched for a player, it'll give you all their stats, the clan, the title. So if you hover over the player's name, it'll show you the title, and it says Big Cheese there. Obviously it's accurate. Then you've got the clan information, obviously the rank in the clan, clan size, clan XP, clan kills. Yeah, so then moving on to the stats, we've got obviously the player's stats. Yellow ones are 120, the orange ones are 200 mil. You can hover over the stats, as you can see, to see each stat's rank, XP, that sort of thing. And you hover over this total level to see the combat level. Plan on adding some sort of XP tracking from runetracker.org, but that's a work in progress, so hopefully soon. Also, from this box you can bring up an RSWiki article, so if I want to search for, like, I don't know, an attack potion, hit Control Enter and it'll browse on the other screen. It'll bring up the RSWiki page for that. Now you'll see that this window is still on top of the browser, which would be annoying. That's because my browser is usually on the other window and I have this visible. So there's a toggle for that in the settings, which I'll get to later. But for now, yeah, we've also got quick links to a timer, which you can drag around, a little stopwatch. That's all it does at the moment, but I want to add some countdowns, that sort of thing. Yeah, just stop and reset. What else we got? Yeah, quick links to the rune track, adventurer's log, etc. for that person, obviously. Pretty self-explanatory. It'll open in your default browser, so if your browser isn't set to, like, Chrome or whatever, it'll probably do it into Explorer, so just make sure that's all set. Yeah, so now we've got the music controls down here. You can control your iTunes playlists at the moment. It's just iTunes for now, but I'm going to be looking at putting in Spotify, maybe some other, like Winamp or something, depending on how good the support is for those in the language environment that I've written this in. Yeah, and you can just do things like control the language, control the volume, next track, previous track, play, pause, shuffle, and yeah. Moving on to the settings. So this is the default user, which will load when you first load that up. It'll populate this field with that. I may as well show you another player just so you know it's, like, working. And mine's a little bit slow because I have slow internet, but it's a lot faster if you have better internet. And you can see here, Zezimo's got all his 120s, whatever. Yeah. And it'll change the name to be exactly how it is in game, so even if you do lower cases like this, it'll put it in capitals for Swomi, for example. Yeah, so the settings. You can update the rune tracker profile for the default user when you launch the program, which is pretty useful if you're like me and you forget to update the rune tracker profile. You can change where it starts, so for example, I'll just unlock it. You can change the start location, just drag it around to where you want it and then hit get, and there you go, it'll populate those. But I'll keep mine just as it is because I like it there. Yep, so you can lock the movement, keep it on top. This is pretty much, you want to keep it checked, otherwise it's just going to behave like a normal window and it'll just go away as soon as you're playing the game, which is pointless. Yeah, you can unlock movement, I'll keep it unlocked for now. This minimize, so you can see how when I minimize it down, so when it's in its normal spot, and then up, if you change this to upwards, it won't change immediately, but pretty much it'll just go up. But I'll show you that now. Actually, I'll move it up here. We'll just save it, just to show you. So we'll minimize upwards. So this is the dual monitor thing. So if your game is always visible, like mine, on one monitor, just check this box and this interface will stay on top of everything. But if it's not, just uncheck it and it'll go away when you open another window so it doesn't get in the way of things. This is obvious. Show iTunes controls. I'll demonstrate this in a second. And that's just the start position of iTunes. You can change the transparency of it. I'll just keep mine. I'll change it so you can see. And you've got the default string. Just leave this. Unless you're using a different client like SwiftKit, then you've got to change this to like SwiftKit or whatever client you use so it can detect the client. Otherwise, and that's just the window title here. Like this is RuneScape here. Or this would be all settings. And this is the autocomplete, so when you start typing a name, it'll add it to this list. Like, I don't know if the name's in this, like, Skype. I don't know. It'll just start, and it'll predict it. Pretty simple. Yeah, so you can save the settings. There's an about box that just shows you the version number and everything. Yeah, we'll save those, and it'll restart in the new position that I set. And now when you minimize up, as I was saying, it just goes to the top now. So it's pretty useful if you want to hide at the top. Also, when you search the name, it'll maximize it. Didn't click anything there. Yeah. So, other than that, we've got auto-updating. So if there's an update, this little taskbar thing will give you a little message saying there's an update available, just click it, and then you can choose to download the update or whatever. Yeah, so this little menu, you can hide the thing quickly or show it or whatever. You can check for updates manually, and you can get to the settings, or you can just exit. That's pretty self-explanatory. What else have we got? That's about it. I will show you the updating interface, but it only opens if there is an update, and I'm on the latest version, so. And you'll notice that it is slightly transparent. I only put it to 90%, but you can sort of, I don't know how good the quality is, but yeah, it is. Okay, so I did forget one thing, and that's the always on top thing, so the RS always visible. Yeah, so if you're RS is always not always visible, and you open like your web browser, it, did you notice it just went away, and then once I go back to RuneScape, it'll come straight back. So it's very unintrusive, but if you have two screens, then yeah, by all means, just leave it always on top, and yeah.